the most important thing is to triage the patient, both downstream and upstream, according to their treatment and isolation needs. In fact, many of our patients now in hospital, they are young students, many of them without office symptoms, and quite a number of them have already recovered from their illness, but their nasopharyngeal aspirate still show the viral signature, but they may have a relatively low infectivity, but still pose a risk to the community. For these two groups of patients, although they are infected, they are physically very well. They are up and about, they don't have treatment needs. The best thing is to isolate these patients. For example, with some of the holiday bungalows and some of these resort areas, so that they can take care of themselves with minimal contact with healthcare staff or other supporting staff. Putting them in the hospital, in fact, wastes a lot of our hospital resources and manpower. And they also pose a cross-transmission risk inside our hospitals. I think that is the one thing that government should consider as quickly as possible. Of course, we need to make contingency plan in case there is explosive outbreak in Hong Kong, just like in many other European or American cities. In that scenario, we need some intermediate care facilities to take care of those patients with a lesser degree of treatment needs, so that the most serious patients, including those requiring ventilator support, they may be put in those acute hospitals, as we are putting all these patients now. We can convert some of the hospital under construction into these kinds of units, or we may also convert some of the quarantine center for such purposes. In case we still have a larger patient load, we may consider some makeshift hospitals in some of the convention or exhibition centers, or even schools, some of the vacated schools. But these are for the worst in case scenario that even our normal care facility cannot cater for them.